Once upon a time, a girl named Hillary set out, exploring missions around the world. She laughed. She cried. She discovered God uses missionaries in the most amazing places. And just when she was almost home, her airplane zoomed towards South America. But that's not the end of the story. Join me for more adventures through the mountains of Bolivia. Time. Hey, Mr. Llama, what's with the snow? I know. Up in the mountains, the air stays cold, so the rain turns into snowflakes. Good thing these guys have warm fur coats. Getting up to La Paz was a piece of cake, but going down, that was the tricky part. Here we go. And I think all the stories are true. Sure, it looks like bushes along the side of the road, but they're really treetops. Our mission was to find Camp Yungas. It's in the jungle at the bottom of the mountain, and this road is the only way to go. The camp director is SIM missionary Dan Hardesty. He makes the journey often.
We have to drive down to basically where the end of that fog is,
right.
Cross over the, on the low side of that ridge and go over to the camp.
Wow.
And the river is down in here that we have to cross. Mm-hmm.
Dan said 150 kids at the camp were depending on us for supplies. Yeah, we had a loud horn and good brakes, but that wasn't enough.
I think I can get in. You know, I think I can cross the river and make it to camp. I'm supposed to send the tractor that's going to work a little bit on the river. If they would do that before we'd leave, then we wouldn't have a problem leaving.
But we may have a problem going against the current coming out.
Yes.
And then what? We get stuck? Raining?
Yeah.
And we walk back to the camp, spend the night?
Well, I don't know. It's a pretty good walk. It's probably about a mile.
I'm ready to go across.
Think again. How about the sturdy, wide, solid bridge?
People call Jesus the bridge that takes us from death to life. But I guarantee he's a lot more stable bridge than the one we're on.
Salvation draweth nigh.
We thought we were clear until we realized our salvation was too busy. So many people to rescue, so little time. As hard as we tried, we'd never make it to Camp Youngus. But it wasn't a total loss. The supplies made it through anyway. Just one big problem. We had to drive back up the mountain. You know something? Missionaries here should be the most prayed for in the world, because death could be right around the corner. If the cliffs don't get you, the rocks will. People in these mountains carry their own emergency repair equipment. After Dan got our truck fixed, he took a break, and we got the scoop on Camp Youngus.
Yeah, I was just happy we were able to send in the supplies to the fellows that are working at the camp there so they could continue on with their work.
And tell us a little bit about that. The camp is still under construction. It's being used, but you're still building.
Right. We're in the process of finishing up a few construction projects on the camp. One of them is the pool. As you saw in the rainy season, the rivers get pretty high. It's dangerous to swim in them.
What's the purpose of the camp?
The purpose of the camp is really threefold. Our first purpose is to evangelize and reach the youth of La Paz. And secondly, it's to train and disciple those youth so that they will be raised up into Christian leaders themselves. Thirdly, we eventually hope to see the camp develop into a missionary training center, an outreach center, where we can train Bolivians to also become missionaries themselves.
Many Bolivian churches don't offer much hope. That's what makes Camp Youngus so important. It's one of the few places people can hear Jesus loves them and wants to forgive their sins.
You were telling us on the way down that people who live in La Paz love to come to the Youngus area, from 11,000 feet down to 4,000 feet. So having this camp located in the Youngus area, where the mountains meet the jungle, is a real, really smart move.
Yeah, they love the green. Any time to get close to the green, because La Paz is definitely not green.
This is Carrie Kinsolving.
And Hillary Welburn.
Reporting good news for the All God's Children newspaper column, right here in the heart of the Andes in Bolivia.